Welcome to Analytics with Nax. In this video, we are going to see about how to read or access data from SSAS Tableau model. Basically, we have built a model and we have deployed the model in the Tableau server, right? SSAS Tableau server. And once you have done that, what are the different possibilities of reading from it? What are the different tools you can use? That's what we are going to see in this video. So till this we are familiar now, we have deployed and what are the different processing options, everything we have seen in our previous videos. And once you are deployed, different tools you can use, right? It's SSMS, SQL Server Management Studio, that is to connect to your client. Like, I mean, it's a client tool that can connect to the server and then read. Microsoft Excel, all-time favorite, the universal tool that you can use to connect to your SSAS Tableau, and you can analyze using a pivot table model. And the main purpose, like, I mean, the Power BI desktop can also consume the data from the SSAS Tableau model. One of the key aspect of once you connect to using Power BI desktop is like it will be live connection. You cannot have more control over here. You can only create some kind of calculated measures, and most of the other changes you cannot have. I mean, implement in Power BI desktop. Any changes to the model has to be done here. Let us try to walk through all these sources once you connect. And all these sources, once you connect, it will read, it will fire a DAX query and get results from it. So all the tools are capable of firing a DAX query can able to connect. I'm just saying only those examples. There are other tools can able to connect to SSAS Tableau model as well. With this note, let us try to search in a demo. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button right now to learn the concepts in SSAS. Let us try to first use SSMS. So we deployed the model here in our server, and this is the database, right? So we connected in SQL Server Management Studio, and we have here. So to write a query, right click on this database, new query. You can either write a MDX, it can also support MDX. I'll go for DAX for now. So to get the data from, to see the data, it all starts with evaluate and fact internet sales. So this is to like select star from table name from your SQL, similar query, okay? If you want to query a table, entire table, you will use evaluate, right? I mean, a select star from table. Similarly, evaluate will result whatever evaluating in this context that will be returned here. I mean, in the query that will be written. So now evaluate fact internet sales. I just want to see the data. This is the query. Now I want to select some table here, some like a product evaluate, and just I want to see how many records and what is this product. I mean, I want to see only this filtering this particular product. It requires a lot of DAX to be known, so people are not so familiar with DAX. Let us try to write it DIM product. And the DIM product English name, I want to filter only one particular product, okay? That is flat washer. It is very small, bear with me, okay? This is how you need to filter one particular record. So it's not very easy for end user to write always a queries in order to analyze much. You can write multiple DAX queries to analyze, okay? This is one way of doing. This is more technical. Most of them are not aware. Just for your information, I'm just trying to familiarize with you guys. So let us not focus on this because it is more whoever tech savvy and those who want to write DAX query, capable of writing DAX queries, go for this option. And if you do not have any other tools to access, and the second option available is like Excel. I have shown SSMS and Excel. Let us try to see that one. Microsoft Excel. So once you, if you are familiar with the pivot table, those who are analyzing the data, they are almost familiar with the pivoting concept. So similarly, you will get it. So here, go to data from new sources, okay, or you can go for get data also. I think get data from database, okay, and you can find option called from analysis service. Provide the server name here. Let me copy it, and this is my server name / naga msbi tabler. I go for Windows authentication. There you go. I can see a model here. You can have a different tabular model. Choose your model, I mean the database, and you can have a model name. Here this name also can be changed, that you need to, by default it will be a model. So once you choose your database, you will have your model or cube or table. Then click on next, then just click finish. It will say some option, just click on it. Now you can see your model comes with pivot table, like all the dimensions comes over here, and you can see the meshes, whatever meshes you have created, that comes over here. So just you can click on sales amount, and I want to analyze by product color. There you go. So these color products are sold this much and over different period. Like I want to analyze by period on top. So in 2010, this is the black color product has sold this much, like that you can analyze. So pivoting, you can analyze it. That is the core concept of it, and it will be much 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 faster from you if you are reading it from the cube. Now finally, I'll show from Power BI. This is my Power BI. Just get data and go for analysis services in this case. And same thing over here, put your server name. Naga MSBI tab is my server name, that is my instance name. Database is optional. You can import and connect live. This is the two options, okay? So import means all your SSIS data will be imported, and connect live means you are connecting live. There won't be any, I mean, data won't be stored in the Power BI layer. I have a separate video in the Power BI playlist. Just go and watch it if you are not familiar. In this case, I will go for connect live. Now again, you will get the option. Just click on it. There you go. So you will get list of fields over here. Now you see a lot of options are disabled, get data, and you have nothing to change. Even you cannot able to create a new column. You see here, you can create only the measure, not a new column. So if you want to create a column, you need to go to the modeling, that is SSIS tabular model, create it here and deploy it in your server. Then from here you are reading it from Power BI. Let's try to create a simple sales measure over here, like what we have put. So this is the data sales using a tab, 29.3 million. I will get this value and put it across different product. Say for example, there will be a huge number of product. Let's go for it. So there you go. So there are different products over here, and you can analyze it. So it's like, I'm not going deep into how you create a Power BI reports here. Just I'm trying to ensure, like, you can, how, what are the different tools you can create SSIS tabular model. Power BI is the one, and this is the way how you can develop the Power BI reports beautifully. That I have a separate playlist, complete playlist, that you can see and learn it. I hope we are good with the things, like whatever different tools. There are other tools as well, I will repeat. So that's it. If you like this video, hit the subscribe button if you are new to this channel, and comment below for your queries. Do remember that data is your asset.